Hi, welcome to UNSW and the School of Mathematics and Statistics. My name is Thomas Britz, and I'll be going through problem 19 in the course MATH3411. So this is about some binary linear code C that's given by a parity check matrix H. Actually, in the first part of this problem, we don't really care about H. We have to prove that the minimal distance in C is equal to the minimal weight in C. So first of all, what are these two things? Well, the minimal distance of C, or the minimal Hamming distance, is the minimal Hamming distance of any two vectors in C. Well, they have to be distinct, but otherwise choose any two vectors in C, look at their Hamming distance, and then try to find when that distance is smallest. So for instance, if we had some code words 0, 1, 0, and 1, 1, 0, then we'd have that the distance between these two, if this is u and this is v, then the distance from u to v, distance between them, is the number of these entries that in which they differ. So 0 and 1, that's different, 1, 1 is not different, 0, 0 is not different, so we have exactly one coordinate in which they're different. So the distance between these two code words would be 1. So what about the weight of the code? Well, here again it's about Hamming weights. So it's the minimal weight of a code word in C except for the 0 vector. So for instance, if the code contains these two vectors, then the weight of the U is going to be equal to 1, the weight of V is going to equal 2. Now, no non-zero code word can have weight 0. So apparently the code, if the code contained this code word here, then it would have minimal weight equal to 1. Now, how do we prove this? Well, we have to show that these two are identical, so let's show that one is smaller than the other and the other is smaller than the one. If we have a vector v in C with the weight of v being equal to this minimal weight. Okay, now since we have a linear code here, we know that the zero vector is in the code. So since C is linear, the zero vector is in the code. Why do we need that? Well, we know that the weight of the code, the minimal weight of the code, is equal to the weight of V. But the weight of V is also just equal to the distance, the Hamming distance between V and zero. So this weight of V is just the number of coordinates or coordinate entries of V that are not equal to zero. That's exactly the same as this. So here we have that zero is a code word of C. V is also a code word of C, so the distance between them is at least equal to or greater than the minimal distance between any two code words of C. So here we have that the minimal weight of a code word in C is greater or equal to the minimal distance of the code. Now we just have to prove that this is also greater or equal to this minimal weight, and then we have this equality. So let U and V be code words with distance exactly equal to the minimal distance of our code. There we go. We can again use the fact that C is linear. So that means that the difference between these two, u minus v, is also a code word. So since C is linear, we have that u minus v is in the code. Why do we need that? Well, sort of similar to the first part of the proof, we have that this gives us the inequality that we want. So we have that d of c was equal to d of u and v. So the distance between these two code words is the number of code word entries, or code word coordinates, that are different from each other. So if we take the difference of these two vectors, then this difference is going to be the distance to that difference to the zero vector. This is just exactly equal to the weight of u minus v. And u minus v was a code word, so the weight of it is greater or equal to the minimal code word weight in C, since we observe that that's not the zero vector, because u and v are defined to be two different code words. So we have that the minimal distance of the code is greater or equal to the minimal weight of the code. So we've shown both of these inequalities. So if we combine them, we get precisely this equality. And that's the end of the proof. Like so. In the second part of this problem, we have to prove that the minimal distance, which we've just proved is equal to the minimal weight, is also equal to this here, which is the minimal number r for which the parity check matrix H has r linearly dependent columns. So if we look at all the columns of H, then we have to try to find the smallest number of these columns, which are linearly dependent. So for instance, if H is equal to this matrix here, then you see that you actually need all three columns if you're looking for a set of linearly dependent columns. So here this number would be equal to 3. So how do we prove this? Well, we're not going to prove it in full detail. We're going to sketch what is happening, what lies at the heart of all of this. To do that, let's consider the product H multiplied by some code word transposed here, call it X. And we're interested in looking at the columns of H. So let's call them H1 to HN. Also, let's look at the code word there and give it some coordinates, x1 to xn. If we multiply this matrix by this vector, we get x1 times h1 plus x2 times h2 and so forth, up to xn times hn. So we get a linear combination of the columns of H. Now, there's one little thing to note here. If we count the number of these x coefficients that are non-zero, so here we could say if there are exactly r, and there's where the r comes in, here we have r non-zero xi's, that will correspond to r terms here that don't vanish. So we could say r terms, or we could say r hi's that don't vanish. So whenever there's a non-zero x, for instance xi, x1 there, then there'll be a term there. If it were to be zero, then the term will vanish here. So we have the same number of terms here, or in other words, the same number of the columns of H appearing in this linear combination as we have non-zero entries there. So that's sort of half the story. Now, if we set all of this to be equal to zero, then two things happen. One, this equation here, this little matrix equation with a check parity matrix, ensures that this code word X is now in our code. The second thing that is true is that we have a linear combination of the columns of H, and that's equal to zero. In other words, these are non-vanishing terms describe R columns of H which are linearly dependent. So the final piece in the puzzle is to see that, well, this number R of the non-zero coefficients, that's thus the Hamming weight of this code word. So whenever you have that the weight of a code word is equal to R, that will correspond to exactly R columns of H, which are linearly dependent. So if we're looking at the minimal numbers of linearly dependent columns, that will correspond to the minimal weight of a code word. And that's just the end of the proof. If you think about the two proofs here, in part A and part B, then we never really used the fact that C was binary. And in fact, let's get rid of that. So we don't have to think just about binary linear codes. We could take any linear code over a field, this would all still be true. We'd have that the minimal distance would be equal to the minimum weight, which is the smallest number of linearly dependent columns in a parity check matrix for the code. So this is actually quite true in quite better generality. Well, thank you very much.